Hi, this is another video for Preptober. This time I'll be talking about something I've always had a difficulty with writing, and that is the ending. I've never really been able to end short stories, which is why I don't really do all that many short stories, because I found ending to be quite difficult for some reason. I don't know, knowing when to end a story, it's just something that I've really struggled with. So here I've got a basic structure for the novel, but I really don't know what I'm going to be doing with the ending. Happy ending or sad ending or ambiguous ending, I don't know. So, Spider and his cohorts rob a bank and escape, seeking refuge in New Kenya for a few months. Somehow the bank robbers are discovered, and people in New Kenya, mainly Shelby Campbell, do not know what to do. They have the choice of killing the bank robbers and erasing them from existence, or hand the robbers over to American or California police force in an arranged deal. And I'm thinking one of the possible endings is the police raid New Kenya and pretty much destroy it while apprehending the bank robbers. That's one possible ending. Maybe the trade-off would be more reasonable. The reason they seek refuge, I don't know. To sort of lay low, really, even though that maybe doesn't make much sense. You know, lay low, sort of get a disguise or something, you know. Go down to the Mexican border, I think it's a cliche you sometimes hear in American crime things. So it's sort of like that. And the sort of, you know, the bank robbers are there and they could just easily get rid of them. You know, the outside forces, law enforcement, don't know they're there. I don't think them staying is feasible, but it's possible, but I don't really think so. I mean, they'll have money, so a trade thing, I don't know. Hopefully I'll avoid any plot holes or things that don't really make any sense. I don't know, I could end in that destructive note. It's hard. I don't know how to end it. I suppose for most things I probably want a happy ending. A very simplistic sort of thing, but reading a lot of novels has taught me that that doesn't have to be the case. Quite a few Philip K. Dick novels, I think, don't have an happy ending. Other ones. I suppose No Country for Old Men by Cormac McCarthy has a ambiguous, sort of strange ending, which is quite hard to interpret. The movie Blade Runner, which is very different from Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep by Philip K. Dick, has, I think, multiple endings. There's a director's cut, and there's other sort of versions. There's a theatrical version. I'm not sure exactly what that ending really can be interpreted. Regarding or disregarding the Blade Runner 2049 movie. I mean, the ending needs to be just one last note done, and that'd be it. But it's just hard. You want to end with a bang. Sometimes you want to end with something conclusive, but that's not always the case, and it doesn't always need to be the case. This is a standalone work. It's not part of any trilogy or series, so I don't need to sequel bait, as it's called, or anything like that. I don't know, I do want to have some sort of realism in this novel. So I do think that destructive ending would be a realistic ending. But that's a very basic structure outline thing. And with all NaNoWriMo projects, I'll see where it takes me. I'll have a very, very vague idea of the story and the structure. But the ending for pretty much most of my work is it ends where it ends. I'm never really sure with NaNoWriMo, it's, you do, I think, feel inclined to go by the numbers, 50,000 and roundabout end. And I did that with the one successful NaNoWriMo. I did that, but I don't really know how many words this thing is going to be. I'm pretty sure that it won't be 50,000. I don't think I've reached my goal. But we'll see. You know, the ending will come when it comes. It'll be what it is. It'll build up to be what it is. But yeah, ending is something I've always had a problem with. Thanks for watching. Bye.